joining us live for NBA basketball on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan along with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. Doris Burke will be reporting from the sidelines. And now a quick check of our starting lineups for both teams. First, for the Pistons, Ish Smith is out there with Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. And it's Andre Drummond at 6'11", 275 pounds, the big athletic presence out of the University of Connecticut inside its center. Then it's Marcus Morris, and it's Harris in at the four spot. And looking at the Raptors, Lowry and DeRozan, they're the backcourt. And at the five, the fifth overall pick in the 2011 draft, a fleet-footed 6'11 big man out of Lithuania, Jonas Valanciunas. Then it's Damari Carroll. The Pistons to start out. Now here is Smith into Drummond, out to Harris. Harris right side, just five to shoot, comes up empty down low.
Excellent. Really solid job, actually, by the defense to get in his way as he was going up for that one.
Lowry with the ball. Now Smith defending. Smith against Lowry. Left side, DeRozan. That falls. Nice feed that time from Kyle Lowry. DeRozan's got the first points up on the board here for the Raptors. Detroit with the ball. Doris Burke has an update for us. Doris?
Well, Stan Van Gundy gave me a few minutes to catch up with him. And he said a big factor in this game will be how well they're able to handle Kyle Lowry. He admitted being a fan of his game, saying he's a tough athletic guard who really competes. Defense, rebounding, attack the paint, he'll take it to you. We've got to be ready to match his motor and his aggressiveness. Kevin, are they up to it?
Thanks, Doris. Pass to Kira. No good on the triple.
Rare you'll see him miss such an open look.
Smith kicks to Caldwell Pope, and he gets it to go.
And I'll bet that's what they talked about before the game, you know, getting the ball inside early.
And it worked to perfection, Clark, on that possession. We'll see how that plays out in terms of being a big part of their game plan.
Lowry kicks to DeRozan. Back to Lowry. Feeds to Carroll. He tries for three. That's good. And about 2 minutes played here in the first quarter. And here's Smith. And there's the pass to Harris. Morris outside. Back to Harris. Six to shoot. Let's it go from 11. And the basket good. Harris has got his first bucket in this one.
He can be a matchup nightmare if he can get it in the paint.
Now Lowry. Mar DeRozan on the wing. Just over 2.5 minutes played here so far in the first quarter.
I love how he establishes his post position inside before he converts.
Smith with it. Lowry picks him up. Harris against Carroll. Harris dishes to Drummond. Rebounded by Valanciunas.
And you saw how quick the defense was. They were ready for him. They got the hand in the face there and made that much more difficult.
Yeah, and every team needs that kind of rugged interior defense because you want to try to distract your opponents when they get inside, and you also want to make them uncomfortable in their shot attempt. And you've also got to love what a forceful low-post defender he is. If he blocks one of your shots, you remember it. He sends them into the stands to make a point.
Toronto shooting their first free throws of the game on this trip to the line.
And just to mention, a season ago, they were very comfortable at the line, hitting about 78% of their free throws.
And that one misses. And he's good on the second.
Well, he did enough there. He made it a two-possession game, at least.
Pistons trailed by four. Just under 3.5 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Smith the pass to Harris. Harris, right side. Shoots a fader. Shot's good.
He got a little fancy with the fadeaway on that one.
Toronto, they've gone 3 of 5 shooting the ball so far. Here is Lowry. He's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. And DeRozan kicks to Lowry. Gets the three-pointer to fall.
You cannot leave him alone like that, especially from long range.
Here's Smith, trailing by 5. Back to Harris. Puts it 5 from 18. And that one's good. Harris has got 6. Raptors leading by 3. DeRozan with it. He kicks to Lowry. Uncovered. And another basket for Toronto.
Yeah, I love the communication and the chemistry between those teammates.
Pistons trailed by 5. Drummond sets the screen for Smith. Drummond the screen. Smith dishes to Harris. Back to Smith. Pistons passing it around. Clock at 4. And it's Harris off the drive. A putback. And it's Drummond with the jam.
Tell you what, they're going to have to do a better job of boxing this fellow out than that.
No one between him and the hoop. You're right, Clark.
Yeah, and you don't want to be giving up, guys. Putback slams. That's not the kind of play that could build confidence.
So, timeout called here, the first for Toronto. The Raptors making a switch here. Patterson's checked in. Toronto leading by 3. Patterson a screen on Smith. Lowry drives in. Shoots it up. No luck. And the Pistons now going the other way. Smith outside. Baseline jumper. And the rejection by Valanciunas. Fast break Toronto. Lowry leading the charge. And the shot is good. And that's now 6 points for DeMar DeRozan.
He presents a defender with a serious challenge, always.
Smith against Lowry. And the shot is good. The Raptors have gone 6 of 9, shooting it well. Hard DeRozan on the wing. Back to Lowry. And the Raptors hit again from deep.
Outstanding start from three-point range. Their shooters are on fire.
It really makes them a hard team to guard because they space you out so well.
Now, here is Smith. A finger roll finish at the bucket.
No he didn't. Did he just break out the finger roll? That's nice.
Raptors leading by four. Now here is Lowry. He's got eight. Patterson setting the pick for Lowry. The feather touch on the finger roll. Beautiful. Lowry's got 10 points.
I don't think they can ask much more of him than what he's done this quarter.
Pistons trailed by six. And the Pistons decide to take their first timeout right here. Aaron Baines comes in for Andre Drummond, and it's John Lure in for Tobias Harris. Here's Baines, Patterson defending. Here's Caldwell Pope. It's hauled in by the Raptors. Here's Powell. There's the pick. The dish to Lowry. Ross passes to Lowry. Right side Lowry. Six on the shot clock. For three, Ross. The rebound by Caldwell Pope. Pistons trailed by six. Now Udrich. Johnson left side. He feeds it to Udrich. Johnson misses the three. .151 left here in the opening quarter. Lowry kicks to Powell. He dishes it to Patterson. The jump hook, and the Raptors tack on two more.
They've wasted no time settling into their offense.
Yeah, they're lasered in. I mean, really making the most of their possession.
There's the pick. Here's Udrich. Now recovering. Udrich dishes to Lure. Pass to Udrich. Johnson from outside. It's good. This time the assist from Udrich. Johnson's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three. And here's Lowry. He's got 10. Lowry drawing the double team. Patterson up top. Kicks it to Ross. Outside Lowry. And they come right back with their own three-pointer. Lowry's got 13.
Guys, his consistency in terms of shooting has really helped them seize control.
Udrich, the pass to Baines. The feed to Caldwell Pope. All sorts of time. Oh, and that one had the right spin on it, and it is good. Caldwell Pope's got his second basket of the game. Patterson setting the pick for Lowry. And DeRozan. Here we go. Back to Lowry. Lowry drawing the double team. Ross. Pass to Powell. Dishes it to Ross. The tray. Detroit with the rebound. Here's Caldwell Pope. Pass to Udrich. And Lure kicks to Udrich. Again, the Pistons score.
It's almost as if both teams are in a zone.
Well, offensively at least, partner. I mean, neither team done jack diddly on D.
So the first quarter wraps up with some nice defense in this one. Toronto ahead. They're up by four. And don't go away. We'll be back with the action for the start of the second quarter in just a moment. All right, the second quarter beginning in just a moment. And guys, what's your take on Toronto so far?
I tell you what, the scoring has come in threes for the most part here so far.
Every time down the floor, it seems they're knocking down the triple.
Here's Powell. He hasn't scored yet. That I'm sure will change. Deep two from Ross. No good off the back of the rim. Pistons trailed by four. Feeds it to Caldwell Pope. He passes to Udrich. Kicks it out to Johnson. Now the pass to Udrich. Johnson. That's good. It's Udrich with the assist that time. And it's 6 points now in the game for Stanley Johnson. Toronto's gone 4 of 8 tonight from three-point land, shooting 50% on the three ball here. And we've played through the first minute here in the second. Ross dishes to Joseph. He kicks it to Powell. The rebound by Caldwell Pope. Caldwell Pope's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. Now the dish to Udrich. He feeds it to Baines. And he banks in the layup. Baines has got his first points of the game.
Almost automatic when he can get the basketball that close to the basket.
Well, defense has to be played earlier in that situation. You've got to fight to not allow him to get that position in the first place.
Ross on the wing. Good on the three-point shot. Ross has got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball.
That's his first triple of the game. It was a dry first half for him from long range.
Now Udrich. Oh! He dishes it to Caldwell Pope. Passes to Johnson. Oh! Trying to answer back, but that three is off the mark. Raptors have gone 1 of 3 to start out the second quarter. Powell, the pass to Joseph. Ross on the wing. And he finishes nicely on the layup. Ross has got 5 points now this quarter.
They've done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball into the paint.
Clearly, they've been the aggressors thus far when it comes to attacking the interior in this first half.
And Udrich kicks to Johnson. Johnson right side. Here's Caldwell Pope. They get it again.
Defense better not make a habit of giving him that shot. I mean, he doesn't miss many of them.
Stolen. Now Udrich. Clark, they've been looking out of sync offensively.
You know what? A basket here would do a lot for their confidence.
The three from Johnson. And Johnson missing again. Toronto leading by four. And just over 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Ross dishes to Joseph. Kicks it to Ross. 5 to shoot. Again, Toronto.
It took him a little while to get into the flow of this game, but now he's definitely found his stride and rhythm.
Here's Caldwell Pope. The feet to Johnson. And they get it. And Johnson missing again.
It just hasn't been a very good day for him, guys. They need him to start burying some of those.
Ross kicks to Joseph. Patterson setting the pick for Joseph. Number 43. Again, Toronto.
And doing a great job here just stringing together solid possessions as they build that lead up.
I tell you, there's no substitute for consistency, Greg. You know that. I know it. You can stay in control of the game. They'll stay in control of it if they simply stay good with their execution of the game plan and don't waste any possession.
Now a timeout called by Detroit.
And really just trying to take the wind out of their sails here, I think. You know, they're on the wrong end of a run and need to just kind of exhale.
Yeah, sometimes you just need to stop the bleeding. Things were starting to spiral completely out of control. And I think a timeout was a no-brainer there.
Andre Drummond's checked in for the Pistons. Tobias Harris comes in for John Lewis. Harris kicks to Smith. Drummond sets the screen for Smith. Dishes to Udrich. And that shot misses everything. Airball on the three. Here's Toronto. 9 points in a row. Good run for him right now. Joseph, that's good.
You know, that's a case there, Kevin, of him making a pass to a spot, and then he let his teammate run right into it. Well executed.
Now Udrich. Pass to Harris. Feeds it to Udrich. Back to Harris. And that is good.
No issues on that one. Good work all around.
Raptors leading by 8. Here's Powell. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Now here's Joseph, covered by Smith. Drummond with the block. Pistons trailed by 8. Smith drives in. Pass to Udrich. Drummond with a screen on Carroll. Back to Smith. Shot clock at 3. Hit the putback. It's good on the putback. Drummond's got his second bucket.
And I also can't get over how much energy he expends rebounding the basketball. He goes all out on the boards every single night.
Powell kicks to Joseph. Let's it fly. Rebound, Detroit. Drummond's got his 3rd rebound tonight. Pistons trailed by 6. Smith on the wing. And it's Smith again missing.
Boy, that's a warm-up jumper there. I mean, when you're a pro, you can't make excuses for missing that.
Carroll with it. Guarded now by Morris. And again, Toronto no luck.
He hit a 3 in the first, but so far has been unable to capitalize here in this quarter.
Harris outside. And the 3 ball is good. Harris has got 11.
Well, he certainly isn't the one to blame for them being in the hole. He's been on the money with his game.
Toronto calls timeout. The Raptors making the switch here. DeRozan with a screen for Lowry. And Joseph kicks to Valanciunas. Tries to snap the cold streak. The shot is good off the backboard. And the Raptors lead by 5. The Pistons have gone 5-12 from the field here in the second. Now Udrich. There's the pass to Morris. He kicks it to Udrich. And another 3 for Detroit.
He can be a forgotten man in their offense sometimes, but the D still has to keep an eye on.
Toronto's gone 1-2 on 3-pointers here in the second quarter so far. Joseph, the pass to DeRozan. 1:36 left in the first half. Joseph dishes to DeRozan. Pocket 2. Tries from 16. That's good. DeRozan's got 8.
If you're waiting for him to miss when he's that open, you're going to be in for a long wait.
Smith outside. On the wing, Harris. Harris, right side. Again, the Pistons score.
What a job he's doing here. I mean, his second quarter has been even better than his first, and that was pretty good.
Outside Lowry. The dish to Joseph. He feeds it to DeRozan. Good ball movement here by the Raptors. And Joseph kicks to DeRozan. Smooth as silk on the finger roll. DeRozan's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Took advantage of some shoddy defense there. They've got to at least get a finger on it.
Here's Udrich. 5 points in the game. Morris passes to Udrich. Harris outside. He dishes it to Udrich. Morris. Here's the three. And another three for Detroit. Here comes DeMar DeRozan. 10 points for him. Rejected by Harris. Out of bounds. Detroit takes possession. Five seconds left in the first half of the game. Here's Smith. No good trying to beat the buzzer. And so it's a close game as we wrap up the first half of basketball. Raptors lead by one. We'll be back shortly live from the Air Canada Center in downtown Toronto. The start of the third quarter, welcoming you back in a closely contested first half so far. Kyle Lowry has just been sensational.
Boy, did he put on a show from beyond in that first half. Let's see if the halftime break has any cooling effect on him.
Well, I tell you what, we'll soon find out, because I guarantee they're going to keep feeding it to him behind the arc until he does cool off.
Valanciunas, good.
You know, with that much of a height advantage, that's exactly what you should do. Take it straight to the rim.
Pistons trailed by three. Drummond with a screen on Lowry. Smith dishes to Harris. Back to Smith. Out to Harris. Shot clock at five. Ripped away. Break Toronto. DeRozan leading the charge. That's good from Lowry on the assist from DeRozan. DeRozan's got 4 assists in the game. Detroit's gone to the three-pointer 11 times tonight, nailed 5 of them. Smith with it. He passes to Caldwell Pope. Kicks to Morris. Clock at 6. Here's Caldwell Pope. Carroll covering. That shot by Caldwell Pope, no good. Raptors leading by 5. Passes it to Lowry. Now the feed to Valanciunas. And that one's good.
Some defensive breakdowns are starting to show up now. Their last 4 buckets allowed have come from very close range.
Yeah, high percentage shots are what they are getting in terms of the attempt. And that's just not going to get it done. They've got to figure it out.
Here's Caldwell Pope. Yes, and it's Smith with the assist that time. Caldwell Pope's got 7.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. 4 of their last 5 makes are from beyond the arc.
And, Greg, it's hard for me to watch this. I mean, the defense practically giving them those shots.
Valanciunas. It's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Yeah, nice strong finish there. Nearly a 3-point opportunity.
Full throttle, pedal to the metal, attacking basketball. I like that.
This is his 2nd trip to the line in this one.
Yeah, 76% from the line a season ago, and most would consider that to be a success.
The free throw drops for Valanciunas. That's also good, so he hits both free throws. Pistons trailed by six. Now a timeout called by Detroit. One of the stories here, Kyle Lowry getting it done today.
We need to make some adjustments because he's absolutely scorching.
Not quite 2.5 minutes played here in the second half. Harris kicks to Smith. Drummond the screen. Drummond with a screen on Lowry. Dishes it to Morris. It's good, the assist that time from Smith. Smith's got 3 assists now in this one. Raptors leading by 3. Now here's Lowry. He's got 15. DeRozan. And it's Kentavious Caldwell-Pope with the foul. That is his first foul of the game.
And really, these are some of the toughest calls an official has to make.
Yeah, but in this case, I think he got it right. I mean, the defender was still moving there and never really had good legal guarding position. He wasn't set.
And Toronto making a change here. Patterson's checked in. Feeds it to DeRozan. Shot clock at 6. Carroll. The Raptors need to get a shot up. From deep 3-point range, it's hauled in by Harris.
This offense's first miss after 3 straight makes to start the second half.
Smith outside. Pass to Morris. To tie. Pistons keep it alive. Drummond passes to Harris. And good on the basket. Book it. Harris has got 15 points.
Oh, terrific work finishing a soft move like that. The finger roll.
Outside DeRozan. Pass to Lowry. Right side Lowry. Number 43. And again, no good by Toronto.
And they'll give him that shot. I mean, he doesn't have the most reliable jump shot. That's a win for the defense.
Caldwell Pope dishes to Smith. Sinks the triple. He's got 7.
Excellent ball movement there, guys.
And that's keyed this run. Passing it with purpose. The D hasn't been able to keep up.
Smith against Lowry. Left side, DeRozan. Back to Lowry. It's DeRozan with the drive. Drummond with the block. Here's Caldwell Pope. He's got 7. Smith outside. He kicks it to Harris. Harris, right side.
Not too much congestion in the lane. I think he could have gotten a better shot that time, no question.
To end the run. And the basket by DeRozan. DeRozan's got 12 in the game.
And Steve, some of the best highlights you're ever going to see are going to come from this guy. Every time he steps on the court, there's a chance he'll perform the dunk of the season.
Smith against Lowry. Smith outside. Caldwell Pope. Harris outside. Let's the three fly. Harris missing again.
You know, 9 times out of 10, he's going to knock that one down. He'll spray that one on you.
And here's Lowry. He's got 15. Number 43. That falls. Nice feed that time from Kyle Lowry. And now a three-point Toronto lead. The Pistons have gone an even 50% from the floor here in the third quarter. 4 of 8. Smith kicks to Harris. Here's Caldwell Pope. DeRozan defending. Harris passes to Morris. Back to Harris. And that one's good. Harris has got 4 this quarter.
And his stroke has been dead on from the outside. I mean, inside, outside, it just doesn't matter.
Toronto calls timeout.
You know what? I think he thinks he can make a few improvements to how things are going on right now.
Yeah, and you know, coaches always are looking for ways to tweak things and change it up a little bit, no matter what the situation is. That's what coaches do.
And the Pistons making a change here. Lewis checked in. Smith against Lowry. The pass to DeRozan. Back to Lowry. 6 on the shot clock. That one wide left.
Boy, there was no hand in his face right there. I thought for sure he was going to knock that down.
Caldwell Pope pushes to Harris. Smith outside. Johnson. Out to Smith. From deep. That one falls. He's coming off the Johnson feet. That's 10 points for Smith.
And they clearly are just destroying this group right now from the three-point line.
Yeah, and the defense knows it. I mean, they are fully stretched out trying to stop the three-point shot and still haven't been able to do it.
Lowry kicks to DeRozan. Right side, DeRozan. Second down with the fadeaway. Lands soft on the front of the rim and drops. DeRozan's got 14 points. Detroit's gone 4-6 from three-point land since the start of the second half. Caldwell Pope passes to Smith. There's the dish to Harris. Down to 5 on the shot clock. And he hits it just before the shot clock expires. Harris has got 19 points.
Man, he's having quite the quarter, converting at a really high percentage.
Patterson setting the pick for Lowry. Outside DeRozan. Back to Lowry. He feeds it to Patterson. There's 1:38 left to play in the third. Smith dishes to Johnson. Back to Smith. Kicks to Johnson. And it's Toronto with the rebound. Patterson a screen on Smith. Lowry drawing the double team. 1:12 left in the third quarter of the game. Smith and wrestling for it there, but no one has possession. We'll have a jump ball. Toronto with the ball. Lock at 6. Lowry kicks to Ross. That falls. Nice feed that time from Kyle Lowry. And that's 10 points now for Terrence Ross. The Pistons have gone 7-12 from the floor since coming out of the break. He dishes it to Lewis. On the wing, Johnson. Johnson right side. Here's Caldwell Pope. DeRozan defending. And Caldwell Pope gets the basket.
Guys, what a back and forth game this has been.
You know what? You're right. Neither side has been able to hang on to the lead for any kind of time at all.
And that's already resulted in 7 lead changes.
The feed to DeRozan. Outside for Lowry. Ross. And it's Lure with the rebound.
Yeah, great look, but disappointing with the miss.
Boy, what happened on that one, Greg? I mean, that's almost an automatic shot for him.
Too long in the paint, and he's hit with a 3-second violation. The Pistons shooting their first foul shot of the game. And the technical free throw is good. That's going to be over and back. Not watching for the line that time.
Oh, no, you hate to see that. Those are just the kind of errors that can cost you in a game like this.
...11 seconds left here in the third quarter. Passes it to Ross. There's 3-pointers off the mark. Here's Udrich. Can't hit. And we just finished the third quarter, and we've got a tight ball game here. The Pistons on top. They lead by 2. Thanks for joining us again as we get set for the fourth quarter. A terrific game so far. In a moment now to quickly take a look at the offensive approach for Detroit.
What a tremendous showing from the three-pointer all through this game.
Well, you've also got to love how aggressively they've taken that ball to the basket and scored off dribble penetration.
He passes to Lewis. No stopping him there. Jams it in as he's fouled. Chance now for a 3-point play. That's on Patrick Patterson. DeMar DeRozan. He's checked in for Toronto. Raptors trail by 5. Screen by Valanciunas. DeRozan passes to Valanciunas. Pass break Detroit. Lure dishes to Caldwell Pope. That's good. That's now 22 points for Tobias Harris. Toronto's gotten a positive outcome on 7 of their 14 three-pointers in this game. Not bad at all. Lowry kicks to DeRozan. Left side, DeRozan. Lowry, he's guarded by Udrich. 6 to shoot. Cross for 3. That falls. Nice feed that time from Kyle Lowry. Lowry's got his 7th assist in the game. A little over a minute of the fourth quarter gone right now. Now Udrich dishes it to Caldwell Pope. Feeds to Udrich. Pass to Harris. The finger roll finish at the bucket. Harris has got 11 in the second half.
Man, have they been effective at getting the ball inside.
I tell you, we're taking a look at some real deficiencies defensively. I mean, they've given up 5 straight good looks in the paint.
And DeRozan, here we go. And he gets it to go. And that's now 11 points now for Valanciunas.
And the deeper we get into this game, it seems like the more the offenses are in rhythm.
Without question, I mean, both of these teams are firing on full broadband bandwidth. I mean, full throttle ahead.
Caldwell Pope kicks to Udrich. Lock at 6. Pass to Caldwell Pope. 16 feet away. And it's Toronto with the rebound. Here's DeRozan, and again it's Toronto converting. We're in the fourth quarter here, just under 2.5 minutes gone. Time call here. The Pistons decide to talk it over. And with a fourth quarter push coming up here, the coach going over the game plan and these players rehydrating themselves with Gatorade, recharging their bodies, refocusing their minds, and getting that strategy down to close out the game. Let's catch up with Doris from the sideline.
In during the break, guys, I listened in on Stan Van Gundy's huddle. He told his team to keep looking for three-point opportunities, saying their perimeter defense isn't doing a good job getting out on our shooters. So let's keep firing away until they decide to guard us.
Thank you, Doris. For those just joining us, fourth quarter here. We're just over 2.5 minutes into it. He kicks to Johnson. Harris outside. Detroit, no good that time either.
One made three for him for the game. Does he focus closer in? Let's see.
And there's a call on Tobias Harris. That's foul number two for him. Terrence Ross has checked in for Powell. Third minute of action now gone here in the fourth. DeRozan passes to Valanciunas. DeRozan dishes to Valanciunas. Good!
And since halftime, this has become an intense ball game.
Simply phenomenal, Greg, the effort we've seen from both sides here.
Here's Hudrick. Six on the shot clock. Here's Caldwell Pope. DeRozan defending. And the shot is good. And the Pistons lead by two.
And he has started to turn it on now after that slow start.
And Joseph kicks to DeRozan. The pass to Joseph. Knocked away. DeRozan against Harris. And Hudrick kicks to Harris. The dish to Hudrick. Back to Harris. He feeds it to Johnson. Five on the clock. No good from outside.
And he's really having all sorts of problems with his jumper right now.
Yeah, big time. I mean, the words that come to mind, ice and cold and disappearing stroke, all with a plot.
And Joseph kicks to Patterson. He dishes it to Ross. Valanciunas out to DeRozan. Hudrick grabs the board.
And you know they wanted that one to go down.
They sure did. Would have loved to tie it up right there.
Johnson, the pass to Harris. Kicks it to Hudrick. The feed now to Caldwell Pope. Passes it to Hudrick. The baseline J. And DeMar DeRozan pulls it down. The Raptors have gone an outstanding 4-5 from the field in the fourth quarter so far. Joseph dishes to Patterson. Feeds it to Joseph. Raptors moving the ball around. DeRozan gets it to go from 18 feet away. DeRozan's got 4 points in the quarter. Detroit's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. And Hudrick kicks to Harris. Harris a screen on DeRozan. Hudrick for three. Good.
Boy, that was a rugged screen set there, fellas, and the defense didn't even try to go through that one.
Toronto calls timeout.
You know, obviously, you know, there's some things out there he does not like and wants to talk it over.
Well, Greg, you play and you envision yourself as a coach as well. So, you know, sometimes you need to make some adjustments.
And the Pistons making a change here. Raptors trail by three. Lowry passes to Kira. Dishes to DeRozan. Fade away. That's good. DeRozan's got 10 points here in the second half. Detroit's gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. Smith drives in. He passes it to Johnson. Yes, and it's Smith with the assist that time.
Smith's got four assists in the game. The Raptors have gotten it done so far from the field here in the fourth, going 6 for 7. Pass to DeRozan. And again, it's Toronto converted. Smith with it. Harris a screen on low. The drive by Smith. Back to Drummond. And it's thrown down hard with both hands.
How about that fantastic finish and the aggressive move, too, Kevin?
Trying to send a message, Clark, with that slam, I think.
And I'm not sure if it was text or email, but he definitely threw that one down.
Outside DeRozan. Pass to Kira. He kicks it to Lowry. Shot clock at 6. That's good. The Pistons have gone 7 of 11 from the floor in the final quarter so far. And some solid puts for them. And it's Smith penetrating. It's stolen by Valanciunas. Now here's Lowry. Number 43. And again, Toronto with the triple. I think, Clark, we can expect a dramatic end to this one.
Well, 8 lead changes would have you thinking that would be the case.
Yeah, no quit by either side, guys. Neither team willing to give any ground.
Smith outside. Harris against DeRozan. It's hauled in by the Raptors. DeRozan's got 3 rebounds now in this one. Left side, DeRozan, Lowry. 1:41 left in the fourth quarter. Back to DeRozan, just 4 to shoot. Andre Drummond grabs the miss. Drummond's got his 6th rebound on the night. Here's Caldwell Pope. Carroll covering. Smith outside. The pass to Harris. Outside Harris. And count it. 2 points with a chance for 1 more at the free throw line.
That's a huge shot.
And that put a hush over the crowd.
Took these fans out of the game in the blink of an eye.
Marcus Morris has checked in for Detroit. A free throw off from Harris. Toronto's gone 2 for 2 from 3-point land to start the fourth quarter. Here's DeRozan. And that one's good. DeRozan's got 24 points. Time running low, guys, and somebody has got to win this one.
This game, as close as it's been, you really hate to see it come to an end.
I agree.
Yeah, well, who knows? We might need overtime in this one. It's been that kind of a game.
Outside. Dish now to Caldwell Pope. Back to Smith. Into Drummond.
Yes!
As clutch a shot as I have ever seen. In a word, gutsy.
And the Raptors call time here. They're behind by 1. There's 47 seconds left in the fourth quarter. There's 47 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one.
With the shot, connects.
Wow.
Huge shot. Listen to this crowd.
Yeah, it sounds like a rock concert in here.
And guys, that was the bucket they have been waiting for.
He feeds it to Caldwell Pope. Six seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Lowry kicks to DeRozan. They double him with Drummond. No one near him. No good. And they go to the intentional foul.
Had to foul and on that occasion to stop the clock. That's the enemy in this situation.
And you know what, Greg? Who knows? A few misses at the stripe, and they're right there within range. You know, late-game free throws are a lot different than early-game free throws in terms of making.
It's the first. That will put them up by two. Trailing by two. 20 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, what do you think?
And it all comes down to this. Still enough time on the clock that they should be able to get a real good look.
Yeah, and in this case, you debate often. You hear guys debate whether to take a two for the tie or a three to win. In my case, with this situation, I think you go hard inside and see if you can get a good shot in close.
Toronto's gone 2 for 2 from three-point land to start the fourth quarter. Here's DeRozan. Ooh, offline. And they stop the clock as soon as they can with the intentional foul. And that makes it a three-point lead. Second one is good. Being both at the line, and it's a four-point ball game.
No mistakes there. I think you can close the book on this one, guys. It's done.
Carroll with the three. Detroit with the rebound. And now they foul and stop the clock. Is the first one. Boy, he wanted that one to fall. And he does get the second one. And that puts them up by five. Here's Lowry. And again, Toronto no help.
And sometimes he can hit that deep three, but it's not a high percentage shot for him.
Yeah, even for him, that's out of his range.
And so the Pistons take the win. They seem to relish their role as the bad guy here tonight.
You know, Kevin, I sense that as well. I mean, they really did feed off all of that negative energy this crowd was directing at them. I mean, they turned it around and used it as motivation to close out a significant win.
Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for tuning in.